In the Greater Essex County District School Board, teachers have been exploring ways of promoting metacognitive habits of mind in students. What is metacognition? Metacognition is defined as knowing about one's own mental processes. Individuals who are highly metacognitive know their own skills and abilities and are able to implement strategies to achieve a given outcome. They are able to match appropriate strategies to situations in order to determine a course of action that will help them reach their goal.
Metacognition to me basically means thinking about our thinking. So taking time to look at the experiences we've had or the things we've read or the conversations we've had with people and to take the time to think about what we were thinking about while that person was doing it. So anytime I'm putting kids in a situation or putting myself in a situation or other teachers in a situation of metacognition, I'm asking them to reflect. Donald Schoen talked about reflection sort of before the action, during the action, and after the action. So he's showing the three places where metacognition might play out.
Metacognition describes an individual's ability to reach a set goal through planning, selecting, and implementing strategies. Monitoring, adapting, evaluating, reflecting throughout the process. Metacognitive skills are interdisciplinary, which means that they cross boundaries of subject-specific learning and support students beyond the parameters of the classroom. Developing these skills helps students become highly adaptable and allows them to take increased ownership of their learning.
If as a teacher I can acquire that intentional skill, that when I'm asking a question I'm aware of it, and I understand what metacognition is, then I'm more likely to play it out.
This video series invites viewers into classrooms where teachers are exploring methods of fostering metacognitive thinking skills in students. These segments highlight some key principles of teaching students to adopt metacognitive habits of mind. The first principle is that students can know themselves as learners. Next, it is important to help students understand that they can increase their own intelligence and actually develop their cognition by increasing their level of effort. Third, by providing students with many opportunities to establish targets and set goals, they develop metacognitive skills. The fourth principle is through explicit teaching of thinking strategies and processes, students can become more metacognitive. Finally, students can monitor, adapt, and evaluate their strategies as they progress towards achieving their goals.